Good morning.
Good morning.
Coffee. Did I? Oh no, it's just damped down. Don't give me shit about my fire again.
It's exactly the fire.
The upside down fire.
I call it backwards fire.
Yep, she's smouldering away. You just open that vent up, mate. She'll start humming again.
The backwards man.
Oh, there's my human pot thing. Chuck that over there. It's morning. It's been raining all night. The snow level's just above our camp, actually. It's not far up, so the river hasn't come up, which is good. Let me put a more ambient light on. There we go. And I'm just hooking into my coffee. Been up for about an hour. Dan's just woken up there. And sending a text out to get a weather report. I know it's raining. It's bloody raining. Chris is going to say, it's raining. What do you want a weather report for? But I'm going to send a text out on the DeLorme satellite texting device that you can buy from Fluid Electronics. Yes, thanks, Fluid, for sending me this to use. It saved me a lot of money and a lot of hassle. Hopefully it's going to stop raining today sometime. We shall see. Oh, it's just got harder, actually, right as I said that.
Yes, I'm still in bed.
It's a nice day.
Nice day,
man. I like being in bed in a backcountry hut. You're actually quite handy to the fire there, Dan.
Yeah, nice and warm.
It got so windy last night after we went to bed. The tent was just. What's happened is we tied this side too tight and that side too loose, and that tent actually moved a little bit on the frame and created a gap along the ground right where Dan's sleeping. So I'm gonna fix that. I'm gonna tighten this side and loosen the other side. Clove hitch, awesome, not that one. This is a great example of when to tie an alpine butterfly. So alpine butterfly in this application is we've had a guy line or a rope on the tent has weakened itself and almost snapped through by rubbing on a rock overnight. So I want to take that weak link out without too much mucking around. Oh, I could tie a double fisherman's in there, but I just want to do it quickly. So I'm going to throw an alpine butterfly in there, retighten the tension on the guy line, get back in the tent. This just in from Kristen, another 25 millimeters of rain will fall this morning. Rain stopping completely by 2 p.m. Fine, Thursday and Friday. It's Wednesday, is it? It's Wednesday, isn't it?
Yeah.
Currently Wednesday. Wind at 1300 meters, 40 kilometers an hour, changing southwest this evening. Fantastic. And I've just sent another text asking her for the freezing level and weekend weather, because it's opening day on the weekend. And I just want to know if Smitty's going to bloody come duck shooting or go hunting. I suspect he's going to go hunting for a deer. Oh well, more ducks for us to shoot, eh, Dan? Hey! Yep.
Yep.
Too right. Too right. That's the thing, you see.
Josh is trying to make me healthy with vitamins. No bacon and eggs.
Vitamin C and chili mix and magnesium with B2, vitamin B2 or vitamin B plus or something. Yes, because we've been burning reserves the last couple of days. I got beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes.
I got beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb,
ribs,
beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, beans,
greens,
potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ribs, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes.
Thank you. blowing his guts out. Must be that southwest punching through, hopefully, that means the weather will clear and we can get out for a hunt. It's stormy. Whoa, this just in. Kiwi bushman caught a tourist driver on the wrong side of the road in Greymouth yesterday. In a video to his Facebook page, James said he directed the car back to the left-hand side. It was close, bloody close, I tells you. Someone else had been run off the road earlier in the day. He said tourists should sit driving tests. This was not James's first run-in with a tourist driver. He previously filmed himself pulling over an Asian driver, that's right, I remember that, in South Wesling, and challenging him for constantly straying over the centre line. Yes, I remember that. I was very nice about it. I said, mate, you need to stay left, or you'll get wasted as by another car. Yes. Anything interesting over there?
Stoat predation.
Hell yeah.
That's our hook. That's our hook hole.
There you go, like that. Back around here. I see it's up. Oh, yeah, a little bit. That's only four. I'll do.
Slippery braided line to a monofilament leader.
Trim it up.
Tidy it up.
Tidy it up. And you're away fishing. 10 pound trap on there.
I was thinking more of a 210 kilo marlin. This is a great knot. For tying lures or jigs on, is it in parts a realistic flutter to the line? Also a good knot for tying your nymphs in a fly fishing application.
Fish on. Got it.
I saw you over there, but what could I do? I couldn't stand and stare. Or come and talk.
I just spied a bull in the exact spot we climbed to yesterday. Right on the exact spot. He's just standing out there in the sleet and the snow, looking around, not really caring about anything. I think it might be a mature bull. It's hard to say because he's not moving around. He's pretty staunch, just standing out here in this stuff. Still raining, 1:20 in the afternoon. 1:20. Supposed to stop raining at 2 p.m. That's what yr.no reckon. See what happens. It's eased off, the river's dropping already, which is good.
Nothing beats a failure but a try.
Almost stopped raining. 2 o'clock. I've spied two nannies and a juvenile and a bull up the head of the valley where we climbed yesterday.
I wonder where I'd be if I upon rely on fate you meeting me. But because
all right, we're rolling. Rolling up the hill. We've spied a mature bull. He's quite a way up the hill, maybe 400 metres, but if we can, maybe more, 600 metres up, if we can close the gap, we can probably get a shot off him before it gets dark. We're not high above the riverbed here, so if we have to walk back in torchlight, we can, it's all good. But it is late afternoon, got about an hour of light left, so I think we might be able to, he's coming down, we're going up, we might be able to close the gap. Possibly, we'll see.
Ready when you are. You got him?
Yeah. No, no. Oh, yeah, I think you got him. Reload, reload.
Hang on, I got me too.
No, he's down. Good shot, bro.
I got me
good
too.
Good shot. Fuck. Keep coming, keep coming.
Is he coming?
Yeah, keep comes. Coming. What, can you see him?
Yeah, I see him. He's going.
Can
he's
you see
going.
Him?
Yep. Yep, yep, down, he's in there. I got me too, bro. Dude.
What's that? Oh, you scoped yourself. You okay? Oi.
You're an angle.
Mate, it's a good shot.
How bad is it? Not too bad.
No, it's good, but the battle's cut. Shit, we were just talking about that too.
But I got the gun.
It smoked and that was a good shot. It's actually quite a bit darker than it shows on the camera. Yeah, that was a great shot. Did he come all the way over that edge, did he?
Over to the, I don't know.
Awesome. I don't know if we can get down, but we'll go have a look. All right, mate, your gun safe. Boot up. Better go grab your pack, mate.
Yeah.
All right, up the hill, get this thing, and then we can come back down the same way we went down last night, down that knuckle. Sweet.
Did you like that shot?
Oh, it was a good shot, mate. It was a great shot. Your eyes looking good, too.
Oh, no, it's the top?
Yeah, beauty. Yeah, that's an absolute killer. All right, sweet as, I'm going to start walking up, eh?
Yeah, you start walking.
Right. And this camera's so good, it makes it look like it's bright as day up here.
Oh, mate. Oh, my God. Oh, no. I shot his, he broke his bloody horn.
Oh,
off.
His other horn broke off.
Yeah.
Oh, what? We should be able to find that.
No, it's here.
Oh, it's there. Oh, that's all right. See how his horns curl back towards his ears there? He's over 12, bro.
He's a beauty.
He's a beauty.
I can glue it back on.
Yeah, no worries. Whew. Meanwhile, I was climbing up the hill and heard something whistling at me. There was another bull way up there, so I shot him, and he came barreling down over into the creek on the other side. We can actually get over there. Might be an idea to come back up here tomorrow for another hunt, because we saw a couple of nannies up here too.
Why don't we?
Oh man, should we get this and get that, or should we come up tomorrow?
We'll
I don't know.
We'll get this and get back. We'll come up tomorrow for that.
Yeah, and go for another hunt. Yeah, come. Yeah, true. All right, I'm going to put the camera down now and help.
Oh, what a bastard.
Help Dan cut this up. Yeah, look at that. Look at see how they kill back in there.
Yeah, good, eh?
Mate, that's an absolute pearler.
Can't believe we broke his horn off.
Bit of a bugger. Well, at least we got his horn.
You ready?
She's snowing now.
Oh, that's what you're carrying, isn't it?
You want me to take that, bro?
Yeah, you take that if you want.
Yeah, I got better, makes sense. I got better boots. You're gonna got gum boots on.
Really appreciate it.
Chuck it up there.
Give us your stuff.
No, yeah, I'll just put the camera away and.
Is that the silhouette on a snowy night? After killing Tahr. How high are we? 1400?
13,
1500.
Base camp's 13, probably, yeah, 100 metres. 1600. 14, yeah, 100 metres above camp elevation, I reckon.
More than that.
Maybe.
Oh, we're hell more than that. We're about 300 metres above camp.
We're up anyway. We're up on the side of the bloody hill. Do you want to just shine that on my jacket here, mate?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, sweet ass. So we're up here on the side of the hill. It's dark. It's proper dark now. We've got to walk all the way down. We're going down the same way we came up, and it's pretty easy to negotiate. We just have to head down on the angle till we hit the spur, straight down to the river floor, and then back to camp. So we're probably an hour and a half away from camp.
We'll be
it's
7:30
tomorrow, 8 o'clock or something. Then we're going to come back up tomorrow to recover the bull I shot, and then we might hopefully shoot a couple of nannies or some nanny skins.
Good to be home. Oh, home.
I got the right way up fire.
Oh, yeah, the right way up fire, and you got to use that damn pump again, eh?
Oh, I just put some coal on, bro. It's fine. There's lots of goodies in there. Josh showed about that. It's going to fill the tent up with smoke, coal smoke, but oh, I don't know.
Yeah, he's another couple of minutes. You're going to have to put some more coal on there, and there'll be smoke all billowing through, choking us, coughing my ring out on the hill again.
So I've seen this Tahr way up the top there. It's on the skyline. And I said to Josh,
mate, look up there. And he's like, what? And I said, mate, there's a big one up there, man. And he's like, all right, we got the binos out. And he's like, yep, there's right.
And he's just off. And I'm just following up, and I went to myself, that's what we're here for. We're here to do that. So we're off, even though it was a long way to go. And we headed up, and we headed up, and we headed up, and we headed up, and he kept looking up, and he went, yep, thumbs up. And he was like, way ahead of me. I'm really slow. I've got my gumboots with a couple of bloody spikes on it. And we're heading up this thing, and we get right up there, And here we are, and we're getting up there, and he took his gun out of the pack, and I thought, right, he's on it, we're on it, he's still there, and his thumbs were up, and he's going, yeah. So I took my pack off, and then he goes up a bit higher, and I went, no, just leave me pack here, I know we're coming down this way, we'll be right. And we get up there, and he goes, right, there it is, and I couldn't see it, man, I couldn't see it at all. It was on the cliff, and it had moved down, obviously, from where we first seen it. And he goes, it's right there, and I was like, I can't see it, man. And he goes, come on, man, you got to see it. I was like, I can't see it. So he gets out his video camera, and he goes, look, and he just zoomed it right in, and he goes, look, that spot there, and then there it was. I said, right, gotcha. So I got the scope, and I'm up like this, like you couldn't believe the angle that I was shooting off. Oh, no, I'm going to scope myself here. And I didn't have a backrest, and Josh is going, look, mate, you need a backrest. And I was like, yeah, righto. And there was a lot of turning and throwing and talking and that, and I'm going, shh. And he's like, you're not listening. I said, I'm listening. Anyway, so we got the backrest out, and I got it on the spot, and I was like, look, mate, I'm not comfortable, hang on. And my feet behind me, I didn't have a grip, and I thought, if this gun, it's a bloody big gun, 7mm. Bloody Remington, isn't it?
7mm Magnum, yep. Oh, I'll just grab a seat. Losing feeling in my bloomin' legs there, squatting down. Sorry, carry on. Yep, the old 7mm mag.
7mm mag, and I shot that the other day, and it had a hell of a lot of kickback. And I thought, mate, if I haven't got a good rest and got it in my shoulder, it's gonna hurt. And I've scoped myself before with shots that I've been up like this. And I was like, oh man, this is gonna hit. Anyway, so I got on it, and I was on it, and this guy, the Tahr, he was looking right at us, and he was slightly on the side. Hopefully the video shows that. And I lined him up, and I went, and he goes, tell me when you're ready. And I went, yep, I'm ready. And I thought, oh, that doesn't feel good. And I thought, bugger it, I'm gonna pull the trigger. And as I pulled it, as I was pulling, the crosshairs went off to the side, and I went, no. And as I was pulling, I brung it back across, and it just went boom, and it went smack me right in the head. Can you see that? There's probably a little bit there. There's a little bit of a gark. Can you see that? Probably.
Yeah, you got not. A gark, yeah, out of your, yeah, face. Yeah.
A wee bit of a gark.
Made your nose even bigger, bro.
Anyway, so that's all right, and blood's running down my face, and he's like, reload. I don't know if you got it. And next thing, what did you say? It was No, I think you might have got it. And then, oh yeah, there it goes. And it was, and he goes, can you see it rolling down? And it was going boom, ba-da, boom, ba-da, boom, ba-da, boom, straight down, man. It was like, yes. And it went boom, boom, boom. And we get up there. And so I'm composing myself, going, oh dear, I've got a sore head. And my face is still ringing. And I was thinking, thank Christ, I didn't have another shot, because my ears were ringing from that. And I was like, right, okay, so I get up there, and he goes, go and get your pack. So I got my pack, and we're off up there, because it was only just down about 20 metres. And I was heading up, and next thing I hear this boom, and I thought, oh no, it's still alive. And then I hear another boom, and I think, well, if it's still alive, he's missed it again. What the hell? And I'm getting up, and I'm going, you're right, yeah, I get up there. And I get up there, and he's way over there, up further, beyond yonder. He's got some legs, this boy, I tell you. Geez, he can move like a bloody Tahr up in the hills. I suppose in Tahr country, you've got to move like a Tahr. And I tell you what, it's bloody tough country. Anyway, so we're up there. And he goes, no, your one's down there. And I went, yes. And he goes, but my one's just over there. And I went, yeah. And I said, get it, yeah, roll down. I was like, sweet. So anyway, so we got this one. So it was getting really dark, and it was sleeting, snowing up there when we were skinning this one. And we nailed it out, and we come down in the dark.
I think your fire's gone out again, bro.
No, look, it's the right way, man.
It's freezing in there.
It's the right way, yeah, but you've left the door open again. You always leave the door open.
I'm freezing to death in there.
This guy was born in
the igloo. This bloody fire's not even going. Look, I can't even see it glowing. Open the door up. Show us, open the door.
Check it out. Ready? You've got to be quick, because it'll go out. Ready? Look, check it out.
Oh, yeah, I've got to open that vent up.
The right way up.
There he is, sleeping Dan.
It's funny, I woke him up.
No, I was already awake thinking, oh, it's time to get up. And then Dan gets up. Oh, sweet, he's up. I said, let's go, Dan. And he said, just close your eyes, back to sleep. It's just the moon. It's just the moon. Go back to sleep. I should have tied my cock in a knot, he says. So, anyway, I'm telling him he's got to get up early because we've got to get up that bloody hill. We should be walking now. And he's still in bed, so I'll put the bacon on. Bacon's cooked, tomatoes are cooked, and I put the eggs in the pot and said, there, mate, eggs are in the pot. Those are your eggs. If you want them overcooked, you can stay in bed. If you want perfect eggs, bloody get up. Glorious day on the hill. Absolutely marvellous. Absolutely marvellous. I've got my coffee there. Put it in a rock. Got my seat. I'm going to start glassing for some tar. Alright, up the hill. Sun's just peeking up on those top peaks there. We're into it. A couple of balls way up top, can't get up there. There's no way to get up there, just cliffs, cliffs, cliffs everywhere. But we're going up to recover the one I shot last night, and a bit of luck, we might see a nanny and a kid on the way, because I really want to shoot a kid. I just want to shoot a kid. It's good having that bloody white covering on everything. It makes the tar easier to spot.
Your face is looking good today, bro.
How good?
Nah, it's just a couple of dings in there. It's not too bad, actually. Doesn't have the classic ring, so he only just scoped himself. Just.
No, I'm hard.
Oh, yeah, he's hard as. Hard as nails, old Dan. Anyone who comes tar hunting in gumboots is a hard bastard.
Morning.
Dan had a couple of beers last night, a few whiskies, and I had a couple of cups of tea and went to bed, and then he bloody kept me up all night talking, yabbering on, and Christ almighty, he talked more than me, this fella.
First thing in the morning, saw a couple of tar climbing up there, up into those bluffs.
We wouldn't have shot those tar last night if we hadn't have come right on the hill, right on change of light. So there you go, guys. You want to shoot a big tar, you got to get up on the hill, start walking while it's dark. Not like us this morning, we bit late. We've been a bit late every morning, actually. Gentleman hunting. But we wouldn't have shot that one last night if we hadn't have been there right on dark, because it was right on dark when those two bulls were coming down.
One thing I really enjoy about tar hunting is not only the harvesting of animals and seeing the animals, it's being up here in this freezing, harsh landscape with the jagged rocks and the extremes, the wind and the snow and the rain and the hot days and the frozen landscape and the sharp rocks poking and the sticking and it's just awesome. And the sun comes out and melts everything and smooths off the rough edges. This ground we're walking on, cold, hard, frozen, unforgiving ground, suddenly turns a bit softer and makes it a bit easier to come down the hill. It's just an amazing place to be, right up here on the mountaintops, and it's different to any other place I've been on earth. I've been a few places, been in the Rockies, South America, Central America, Europe, Northern Europe, Australia, and New Zealand just takes the cake. It's the icing, look at that, there's the icing. Right there. That's all the colours. That's the all the different shades of grey in the rocks, and the different colours of the tussock. The light browns, the dark browns, tans, gold, the greens. You've got fluorescent green in the rocks, red, crimson, white. It's just amazing. All the shades of green. An amazing, vibrant place to be. It really is. It's a bit of a shock to the senses, actually. Sensory overload would be a good way to describe it. Sensory overload in the Southern Alps.
Well, Here's the one I shot last night. Here he is. Down the hill, ended up in that waterfall. And now I'm just gonna roll him down the hill down to Dan. And we'll deal with him down the bottom. He's just on 12 inches. Another really nice skin. This one's got a bit more of a blondie mane. Whew! Alright, and he's not soaking wet, he's just wet underneath, which is good. A little bit disrespectful, but I don't have a knife when I was down there, so instead of bringing the knife up, I'm going to bring the tar down. Man. Whew! Knackered, only mid-morning. Long down the hill, hopefully we'll get a nanny and a kid too, just around that corner, but we'll deal with this one and then we'll make a plan. Everything's coated in about an inch of ice, so it's extremely sketchy down here. I'm gonna have to put the camera now down, just go down, crawl down backwards using my ice pick to anchor. Yeah. Bigger than Dan. By the time it took us to skin that tar, which wasn't very long, it's clouded over and it's snowing, which is good. At least it's not raining. It's shit when it rains. Wow.
The next one.
No nannies up here. I don't know what we're going to do now. I'm going to go back to camp. Who knows? Mate. This pack, the Stony Creek Buller, 60 plus 10, is the mutt's nuts. Oh, it should have this on it, and it should have that on it. That'd be cop bloody useful. Oh, why don't you try one of those? And Stony Creek said, hey, them's bloody good ideas. We're gonna try those. And they did, and mate, I'll tell you, it's great. You can use it as a little day pack. You can use it as a big multi-day expedition pack, and it's great for hunting on the hill. Compression straps, it's got a whole bunch of different features. Actually, I'm going to do a review on this pack. I've had it for 2 years now and I've thrashed it for 2 years, and it's just fantastic. Now that I've been using it for 2 years, I'm more than happy to do a review because I know its pros and cons, and I know it can handle the jando and last the distance. We've got to walk all the way back down the valley, have a nice cup of tea. That's better than beer, isn't it? He means yes. Yeah, yes. We don't have much wood left, so I'm just doing a bit of a wood mission up here. There's our camp right down the valley. A few avalanches brought this wood down, so hopefully we have enough to get us through the night. Maybe a nice fire in the morning. Wouldn't that be lovely? Yes. Job done. Bloody Dan's sleeping again.
The lead actress.
It's mid-afternoon and he's snuggled up in his bed. He did this yesterday. I said, don't, because then you'll bloody stay up all night and won't be able to get up in the morning. Sure enough, he stayed up all night, yabbering and carrying on, drinking beer and whiskey and talking to me while I'm trying to sleep.
You were awake.
I was trying to sleep. And then I'd actually drifted off to sleep, and then he bloody woke me up again. And then this morning, he was impossible to get out of bed. I yelling and screaming and kicking him and all sorts. So, I'm just going to stay here and annoy him to ensure he doesn't sleep this afternoon.
Annoy him more.
Oh yeah, annoy him more, because I've been annoying him all day, actually. Incessantly, it's been just, wait, where's my damn thing? So I'm going to annoy him some more.
Need annoyment money.
Now he wants annoyment money. Bloody hell. Annoyment money. I never heard of the like.
Here it goes. What about the bloody danger money?
just as I was walking out of the tent, Dan mumbles, oh, I don't know if we'll be able to do the opening morning, so you may not see him opening day, by crikey. He'll be out Sunday morning. No, he'll be out. He'll be out opening day, because I'm going to tucker him out. I'm not going to let him sleep now. And we're going to get up early tomorrow, and then he'll go to bed early tomorrow night, which is Friday night tomorrow. And then he'll be able to get up early on Saturday to shoot some ducks.
Jesus.
What's that?
What the f*** are you doing?
Oh, just a bit of target practice. Making sure it's shooting straight.
What are you doing?
Sorry, did I wake you up? Well, so sun's just coming off the tops of the mountains now. You know, start finding some animals. I see one bull way up on the horizon, miles away. Another bull miles away up there. Nothing within shootable distance yet. It's our last night here. We're out of here tomorrow mid-morning, so tomorrow we'll just get up and camp, but hopefully we'll get a nanny and a kid tonight. That's the plan. We shall see. We're not going to go way out the valley, we're just going to hunt local, so to speak. Yeah. No tar tonight. Time for a fire. Cook some dinner. Have a whiskey. Hang out in the tent. Home James. Tomorrow. If the weather doesn't clag in, which it may do. And that is the old upside down fire humming. She's a humdinger.
The old upside down fire, Christine.
Well, that's the thing, you see. The thing with stuff is,
just never know.
You just never know, exactly.
It's funny that the...
Yes, glorious day, glorious. Look at that magnificence. Up early today. Dan was on the bearsies last night. I went and slept on the ground further up the valley so he didn't keep me awake. Now, I'm gonna go find a log to a rock to put a log under. No tar. I've seen one tar this morning. I was up since first light, glassing, hoping there'd be one down low that we could go shoot before the helicopter gets here, but nah, the only tar I saw was way up the top of the hill. So, home James, duck shooting tomorrow. Duck shooting! Oh, hopefully duck shooting, hopefully not just duck hunting. No monster bull shot, but we got Dan his 12 and a half inch, maybe 13 inch trophy. I'm pretty happy about that. And a glorious time spin up the hill with a real good bugger. And that's what tar hunting's all about, folks, just hanging out with your mates. For me, the trophy is the memory, and also the skins. I really like the skins. Might have said that about 25 times already. But it's just something about being up here with one of your best mates, up in the wilderness, gallivanting around the hills, pushing yourself to the extreme, and just having a jolly good time. And there, I'll leave you at the end of another short film. Hope you enjoyed it. And once again, if you are one of my supporters on Patreon or the Kiwi Bushman website, thank you once again. I really appreciate it for enabling me to live this life and do what I love for a job. Vash dash kashia sim sika. What does that mean? I am the ditch bitch. It's our collection of trinkets for the next fellas to find and go, ooh, that's a nice collection of trinkets. Happy as Larry.
Can't you be true? You done started doing the things you the hill. I saw Maybelline in a coupe de ville. A Cadillac rolling on an open road. Nothing out to run my V8 4. A Cadillac doing about 95. Moves bumper to bumper, rolling side to side. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the thing you used to do. A Cadillac pulled up to 104. My phone got hot and wouldn't do no more.
Catch up.
I tooted my horn for the passing lane. My rainwater blowing all under my hood. I knew that I was doing my motor good. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the thing you used to do. Like a ton of lead, 110 and a half a mile ahead. Cadillac looking like setting still, and I caught Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back.